This is the Apple Dongle DAC. Every time I say that, I laugh because it's such a silly term, but Dongle DACs have been around for a few years now and have been the subject of perhaps a little too much flack from both audiophile and techie alike. I kind of understand why, because when these first came out, they were compensatory devices to make up for the fact that headphone jacks were being taken away from us. When Apple started out off with their iPhones, they made a dongle DAC for their Lightning to 3.5mm jack. But in 2018, they released this, a USB C to 3.5mm jack that they made for their iPads when they eventually took the headphone jack away from the iPads. But in doing so, they finally made a device that was available to all of us Android users as well. Now, this is a digital to analog converter, and that is its one job, to convert the digital signal that goes in here to an analog signal that goes out of here and into whatever component you'd like it to go to, an amplifier, headphones, earphones, what have you. And it has to do so without adding or subtracting anything from the mix. That is to say, it shouldn't color the sound. Because, I mean, at the end of the day, we're not trying to listen to this, we're trying to listen to the music. And in that, this particular DAC is a shining example of just how that should be done. I'm going to leave a link down below to Audio Science Review where the measurements are available, but basically, the frequency response for this particular device is flat. And despite what some people might tell you, flat is not a bad thing. Flat means transparent. It means what goes in one end comes out the other. Unaltered, just changed from digital to analog. Add to this incredibly good signal to noise ratios, very good synad values, and really, really low harmonic distortions. Measurements that this excels at even when compared with devices like the iFi DSD Micro or even the Cord Mojo, devices that are orders of magnitude more expensive than this. Now, it's not all great. Like any other device, it has some pitfalls. For example, it's not capable of the greatest amount of amplification, so if you need to drive, say, the HD6XX or something beyond that, then it's probably not going to be enough just to use this. Of course, you could always take the output from this and then amp it up, and that would work just fine. But if you pair this with, say, a humble pair of IEMs or headphones that don't require that much juice, then they do just fine. The other issue is if you use this with Android, then your level of volume that you can achieve from this is dependent on your device. Different devices seem to handle it a different way, and really that's more an issue with the way Android is implemented in various devices than the DAC itself. But get everything right, and what you get here is an incredibly transparent, low noise output digital to analog converter. And the cherry on top, really, and this is the important bit, is it's under $15. Utterly flat frequency response, very low harmonic distortion, incredible signal to noise ratios, and low impedance outputs, all of which can be had for under $15, sometimes $10. If that doesn't get you to rethink how much you need to spend for good audio quality, I don't know what will. But that begs a question. What is it that goes into this end that would complement this? What IEM can we pair up with this that follows the same ethos of minimalism and elegance and produces the most transparent, most revealing of sound signatures? Can we pull off an extreme budget, high-end audiophile setup? Well, I do have something in mind, and to those of you who are subscribed, you might have a good idea as to what I'm talking about. If you haven't subscribed yet, then now's a perfectly good time to do so. But we'll continue this conversation in the next video. I'll see you there. Stay happy, stay peaceful, stay colorful. Namaste.